everyone, and welcome back to the Wild Wild North, where we are working on the Meadow of Horses, trying to build up our little farming community. And it is truly the early homesteading days right now, where we are still taming the territory, we are still gathering the resources, and we are still harvesting our very first tomatoes, which I was so excited about. So we've had more tomatoes and soybeans grow, and I was just so thrilled. I might have to add, in fact, we should make this garden bigger. And in fact, we need to go and get some pumpkins, because today we are going to try to breed some of our horses. And to breed our horses, we need pumpkins. And I have a very specific, I missed a zebra. So we'll have to catch that zebra too. But I have a very specific horse color from the Mo Creatures horses that I want to breed for. It's a tier 3, and I know that doesn't make any sense to you yet, Pine, but the various colors of Mo Creatures horses are actually called different tiers, depending on how complex they are, if you can only get them through breeding and stuff like that. Like all of these pepper lookalikes up here, those are tier 2 horses. And today, I want to actually breed our pepper lookalike. And by the way, look, behind the bamboo, there's a snow leopard. That is so cool. But I want to breed one of our peppers with a white horse and get a really pretty horse as a result. And there's Sunflower's potential mate. I think they like each other. And our chickens have grown up as well. So we're going to pop in here real quick. I just feel bad because our chicks don't have much. I want to give them a little bit of barley and some buttercups. Maybe put some daisies at the back here so that they've got a little bit more going on in their room. There you go, chickens. In their little pen. Our very first chickens! One day we will build a glorious chicken coop here in the Meadow of Horses, where this will be more based around the farming stuff and the farming supplies. So I'm pretty excited about that. But for now, Lily, Tate, Pine, you guys want to come with me? We need to go find some pumpkins, and we need to go harvest up some apples and see if we can find a white Mo Creatures horse. A white Mo Creatures horse. That's what we're looking for. And also, I need to see, because to tame them, you need apples and a crafted saddle. And I think I brought a bunch of crafted saddles. Hello, horsey. I'm going to get hungry, so let's go ahead and gather up these wonderful cherries to keep me fed. There's a lot of cherries. We should probably do something like cherry orchard related over in the Meadow of Horses. All right. And I'm so excited. We're going to have little baby horses. And apparently it takes a while to get them, and you have to keep the horses that you're trying to breed a certain distance from all the other horses. So that's going to be kind of tricky too. All right, what's going on down here? Ooh, little cavern. More blueberry bushes to take to our little chicks. More strawberries to eat. Ooh, I got to spread these sugarcane because we're working on spreading those. I could have sworn, and there's another zebra. So I did miss some zebras. I'll have to collect them so we can take them to the safari zone. I could have sworn that there is like a little cluster of pumpkins over here. Because I thought I saw them when I was riding on Sunflower. Oh, there's a mole! Look at him, he's digging! Oh, it's so cute when they do that. He's really working pretty hard down there. Oh, and there's like a little, no, back off! Back off, goat! These are my cherries! Go away! Oh, I just tamed this goat! We're going to name it Cherry, because it ate my cherries. Cherry, dang it. What, do you want some too, pig? Fine, everybody can have some cherries. Oh, look at him. Look at that greedy goat. Are you okay? What a weird little goat. These cherries do not fill you up, by the way. I will have to find alternative foods. Is that apples? Oh, those are apples. So we'll go harvest those apples, and we have an apple tree that was donated that we can go harvest from as well. We can't cut down these trees because there's ints nearby. I do need more oak wood. There's lots of moles here. We can come over here to like gather up some moles in the future. Oh, I guess only one of these apples is ready to be picked. Oh, and there's a creeper and a couple rats. Well, let's just go this way. Today's supposed to be a day about breeding horses. I might have to... there's another zebra. I actually might have to get Sunflower, because we need a white horse. Huh. Well, come on, Lily Tate Pine. I could have sworn I saw... There's a panda. We'll have to remove the panda from the inappropriate biome it is currently in. This is the farming biome. And we'll put the panda in the panda reserve that we're building back at the main zoo. My goodness. Lily Tate Pine, I could have sworn I saw pumpkins growing nearby. I might have to get on Sunflower and do a quick sweep for pumpkins. And also a white horse, because we need specifically a white horse. And here's another blueberry bush. Gonna give it to the chickens. Oh, I do love being out in the wild. Look at the size of that glorious snake. I wonder what kind of snake that would be. I'm not really sure. Like a boa? I kind of want to grab one of those snakes as an anaconda. I saw an anaconda give birth on a video yesterday, and it was so awesome. They actually are, they give live birth, basically. They retain the eggs, and then anacondas give live birth under the water, and the babies are instantly independent and so cute. Oh, little baby miniature anacondas. All right. And she was pretty chill while they were recording her. She's just like, what's that? Whatever. Pretty cool snake. Really love how beautiful. They're so awkward on land, anacondas, and they're so beautiful in the water. The reason they can get so big is because they are water snakes. All right, my chickens! Oh, I feel so much better giving them some flowers and barley and berries to eat. All right, lily, tape, pine. I've got to take sunflower because this is a time-sensitive matter, the breeding of horses, cherry. Oh. I guess I'm responsible for you now, Cherry. I'm gonna take you to my sons. And okay, I hope, can I pick the goat up like this? Or is it gonna eat my safari in a ball? Cherry, how do I move you? If you won't get my safari net, how am I supposed to move you? Don't eat that. You brat! Cherry, you can stay out here for now. You just ate my safari net, my reusable safari net. Oh my gosh. Those are expensive. They're also kind of rare. All right, and then there's these patches of sewage and oil, which we're actually going to be using to fuel our machines that we will have in our farm. So that's going to be interesting. We also will have to remove the ostrich population from the area. They're not supposed to be here. There's another zebra. They better not just be respawning in here, because that would be silly. All right, there's a deer. Here's all of our animals in the barnyard. Now, there's our apple tree. Is there a white horse? We need a white horse. There's a pretty horse. Oh, wow, there's like some lions. We should take those guys and put them in the safari zone too to build up our lion pride. Huh, I could have sworn we would have like a white horse in the area. Did I bring one with us? I know I brought back some horses. Well, I guess we're not breeding the white horse. We'll have to search for a white horse, I guess, because we don't have one. Huh, Pepper. Well, let's see. One second. I've got to think. So we'll breed Pepper with... A pepper with a pepper just makes more peppers. But a pepper with that pretty horse makes that pretty horse. We really do need, like, the white horse for what I'm thinking. I guess we'll go tame that really beautiful horse I saw. And we'll start there, at least. Also, we still need pumpkins. So we'll go on a search for pumpkins. We'll try to find some wild pumpkins nearby. Alright, gotta gather these apples. And I need to not eat these apples. Because these apples we will need them to tame the horses. Sunflower, I actually think I'm a little underprepared for this. All right, let's run in here. Hello, Pepper. Hello, Aurora. All right, and we have these saddles. Oh, good, we've got some pumpkins in here. Yes, so we can use the pumpkins for breeding. I might actually even plant these pumpkins. Oh, look, we've got more daisies I can add around the house, maybe. I don't know if I want to use red daisies, though. Yeah, more saddles up here. Hopefully that'll work for taming. I don't have my amulets either. Sunflower, this is quickly devolving into not having been adequately prepared for this little adventure. So there's these pretty horses. I wonder, hang on, if I breed you with you, I think we're just gonna have to collect like the different types of horses for a minute. Oh good, I've got at least 2 apples, 3 apples, 4 apples. 5 apples. Hello, beautiful. How are you? I don't have any of your kind yet. And there are those horses over there. There's the brown horse. If I have the brown horse, like I have a little chart that shows you how you can breed the various horses. So brown horse with a pepper horse gives you brown horse. All right. So this is a little more complicated than I thought, Sunflower. little more complicated than I thought. But it should be okay. So we have scaled back our ideas from breeding the horses. Let me settle down over here. And let me pick up my bed, which is apparently hard to pick up because it has the little wood. And I'm going to put my bed properly in the bedroom. Right there. Yeah. There we go. We're going to go to sleep real quick, and we are going to go tame that gray horse, because the series of events, clearly fine, Lily Tate, we might have to go home and get some more stuff. All right. Sunflower, let's come this way. Oh, here we go. It's the white horse! It's the white horse! Oh, Sunflower, hang on! Ouch, 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 ouch! I'm sorry, Sunflower, I got overexcited! The evilness of the stinging nettle. Ow! I'm sorry, Sunflower, hang on, let me gather up some Geischel greens. There's some right here. Hang on, I'll fix this. I've got this. Geischel greens. Okay, here we go. I'm so sorry, darling. Is that better? That's better. Also, this is a really cute bunny. I kind of want to catch this bunny, too. But for now, we are catching this white horse. So, interesting. Will you get into the net? Thank goodness it got in the net. Oh, this is wonderful. I hope this works. So now we're going to head back home. I really hope this works, Sunflower. And we're going to see if we can tame this horse. And then we're going to see if we can breed this horse with one of our pepper horses. All right, we'll settle down over here. Sunflower, darling, let me check the area. All right. Mom thinks it's safe of all evil stinging nettles, so we should be good. All right, so then I'm going to come over here. And I think the only way I can move my peppers without having a... I need to put a saddle on them. Because without having a creature or a pet amulet to move him. Pepper. He's like, I don't know how to be ridden. This is weird. Hang on, Pepper. I just need to get another saddle. Where are we going? Okay. You really have a mind of your own, don't you? You're the chosen Pepper. I've got you a very beautiful... really, Pepper? Really? This is how it is? Oh my gosh. We're learning. This is why we're here. So we can figure out how we're going to do this. We're figuring out the hiccups that we might have in our farmyard. And that is that the horses couldn't get out of here. But now they can. All right, Pepper, we're going to go straight. Let me move the cow. Stay, cow. I have to open up both gates. And Pepper? Pepper, it's an open gate. Thank you. There we go. All of our cloned Peppers, which is just totally awesome. He's a very slow old horse, so we might breed. What we might do is try to breed for really, really good horses, because I think you can keep their traits, and that's really awesome. There we go. So now we have him, very slow him, inside of this nice private area. I think it's away from a whole bunch of the other horses, so that should be good, because apparently if they're close to any other horses while they breed, then it just won't work. So let's put down this horse. She's a lovely girl, isn't she? See, can I feed you apples? Oh my, you eat a lot of the apples. Okay, now can I ride you? Whoa, easy there. Whoa, she's a wild girl. She's trying to escape. It's a bit of a rodeo. We've got this, though. I'm not worried. Oh my gosh, she's doing damage, like, every time she chucks me off. I didn't know that would happen. And Pepper got out. That's fine. apparently my horses don't want to breed, but that's okay. He's probably just alarmed. He's like, who is this woman? She's just going nuts. Okay, easy girl. Easy there. We're all right. You're okay. Oh boy. Oh, this is quite the rodeo. This is actually kind of exciting. Oh, finally. I think we got her. I saw the hearts. All right, I think we've got her. Yay! And now we just need to put a saddle on her. Hello, lovely. I'm going to give you your own little saddle. Hello, my dear. Oh, she's fast. Oh, hopefully any child that she and Pepper has will be much faster. Pepper, are you less alarmed now? Less alarmed by your potential mate? All right, I'm going to bring you in here. I don't know if this will work because this is how we're learning. Horse breeding 101. All right, I've got two pumpkins. One pumpkin, two pumpkins. No, come on. No, I need you to mate with him. No, you're supposed to be able to mate with him. He's interested. Dang it, what do I feed a mo creature's horse? I think a cake? Do I really have to make a cake in order to... Really, come on. Come on, girl. I only had one pumpkin. Well, we're getting a little bit closer, guys. So give me just a second. I'm going to figure out what we're missing. I think it's a cake. So 1 second. Aha! I figured it out. It's a golden apple or a golden carrot. And I have a golden apple. So this is victory. Victory. Okay. And we'll give you the golden apple. All right. Come on. Come on. He had this. Oh, they both have the love hearts. Nope, go towards him. No. Okay, Pepper, you might have to go towards her. Because she's being stubborn. Here you go. Here you go. And now, my friends, we actually have to stay in the area, apparently, for this to work for like 5 minutes. And then there might be a baby. Okay, you both have the... Yes, they both have the hearts! We have hearts! We have hearty heartness on our horses. I hope that works. They seem to be following each other around. I hope this bodes well. Does this bode well for our first foal? What do you think, Pepper? Do you like her? But alright, now we have to just like stick in the area and see if a wee baby is born or not. So that's just kind of like sitting here. Oh, come here, Apple. That's just kind of sitting here. But yes, sorry about that. It's my very first time breeding horses. And we're trying to breed one mo creature's horse with a vanilla horse. Ooh, there's my apples already. Thank you very much, so much, Chippy. Because this is the apple tree planted by Chippy, the equine apple tree. And I'm going to keep an eye on these guys. They better stay with each other. Because I think they have to stay like right in the same block radius. Or else it won't work. So actually, I think I'm going to get a fence and a lead out, like if I have any leads, and like make them stay right next to each other. It's like, you guys, stop wandering away. You will ruin your chance. Pepper, don't be looking at those other horses. You need to stay right here. There, maybe that'll help. We'll have to see if this assists the baby horses. Stay. Okay, I think they have to, like, stay exactly in the same area. Good. And I can't leave the area either. So, I don't have any more leads. Ah, and I can't leave the area. Okay, we're gonna have to fence them in. I think we're gonna have to fence them in. In fact, we can fence them inside the little horse stable we have, huh? Alright, let's put her here. Stay. Hey, back up. Stay. Good girl. Now we're going to take Pepper's lead. And we're going to get on Pepper. Pepper, come this way. Alright, stay. There we go. Love mode activated. No, Pepper, come back. You two are so stubborn. There we go. Alright. There we go. There! That should do it. That should keep them in the same radius. In fact, I'm even going to make it a little smaller. Hopefully that will work. So I'm really hoping that'll work. And I will see you guys in like 5-10 minutes. And we'll see if this was successful or not. If we have a baby. So I will see you guys then. You guys, look! 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 It's a new baby! It is a new baby! I was putting up torches for the night. And then a little notification popped up that says, name your new pet. And we have a new baby. It is a tier 3 foal. Look at it. Oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. Look at this coloring. I love it. So this is Jigsaw. Jigsaw is actually the name of an heirloom pepper plant because I love to name our horses after heirloom plants. I just think it's really cool. Oh my gosh. Look who was trying to eat us the whole night and I didn't even know. Well, that's exciting. But we now have Jigsaw, and it looks like Pepper was actually the mother. So, oh, look at our first little foal. Our first foal. I'm so happy. This is going to be wonderful. We are going to breed up so many wee baby horses. This is going to be fantastic. Oh, look how fast Jigsaw's growing already. He's not going to be a foal for long. Well, hold still, Pepper. I'm trying to get a picture of you with your new child. Oh, Jigsaw. Oh, family photo. If you guys would just hold still. There we go. Dang it, Pepper. But here we go. We have our very first foal. Oh, this is wonderful. This is wonderful. So I'm really happy. This will be fun. We'll do the horse breeding. We will figure out how to get all of them properly lined up. And this, I think, is going to be the yard for all of our peppers. And Jigsaw and Jigsaw's mom will go to other yards. Jigsaw might be one of like our very first horses. I can't wait till Jigsaw's old enough to ride and we can see how fast he is. Is he going to be as fast as his very slow mother? Or is he going to be as fast as his much faster father? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And jump. And jump. Whee! All right. So this will be awesome. We'll get the farming going. We'll start adding NPCs. We will start adding more buildings. We will start adding more names to the villagers. It's going to be awesome. Do you have a name? Yep, this is Melon Belly. Melon Belly, who watches over this yard. So this is going to be really fun, guys. And we have our very first foal born. And we'll work a little bit more in our beautiful farm tomorrow. Just kind of getting things established, set up. You guys will see all of the awesome sauce work that I will hopefully get done while I am gone for a few days. And then, well, we're going to have to figure out more adventures. There's definitely a lot of ostriches that we might need to assist, and I really want to work on our bamboo forest for our panda reserve so we can get that started, and there's just so much other stuff to do. Always so much to do in the zoo, and so many horses, and so many fun horse-related things we can do. So I will see you guys later, okay? Bye-bye!